And that was a nice blast to the past. That was the Beatles with I Should Have Known Better. And before that was Elvis Presley, Are You Lonesome Tonight? You're tuned to KSQM 91.5. It's 3 minutes to one. In the 1 o'clock hour, we are going to have Ian MacKay come in and be in the booth or in an adjoining booth. And he is going to talk about his upcoming ride in the wheelchair along in the ride through the Redwoods, I think. He's on the front page of the Peninsula Daily News today. Well, let's hear from Farm Strong with Holding My Own. KSQM 91.5.
QM 91.5 Squim.
And it is 1 minute past one, and I neglected to mention to you, so I want to tell you right now, tune in at 2:30 for the Senior Report made possible through the support of Sherwood Assisted Living. So I'm going to go ahead and turn Ian's mic on. Can you hear me, Ian?
I can hear you, Susan.
Okay, awesome. Well, it just took us a little bit to get things organized. I don't know anything about the technology, so we had to get you in the booth and get you set up with earphones and everything. So I want to make sure I have your last name pronounced correctly. It's MacKay, right?
That's correct.
Okay. It's usually spelled out phonetically for me, but I went a little brain dead for a few minutes. Ian MacKay is in the booth. Well, he's not in the booth with me. There is a wall separating us because of COVID. But Ian MacKay is the founder and executive director of Ian's Ride, a 501c3 nonprofit. in the state of Washington, and he was an avid cyclist before a bicycle crash in 2008. And I was reading in the paper, in your website, I should say, when I found out that you were going to be in the booth today, that you have ridden for 1,000, how many days consecutively have you been out riding?
Ooh, so it's in the 1300s. The last day I missed was Halloween 2016.
Okay, I know it's over 1,000 consecutive days.
Yeah, you know, and that's in the snow and in the rain.
And you usually ride about 8 miles a day?
Well, that's what the average ends up being after the end of the year. But there are certainly those snowy days. It's closer to at least 1 to 2 miles.
Yeah. But to get outside.
Hey, it's important to me.
It is important.
You know, nature is the best medicine.
Oh, wow. You know,
and we live in a place where you really have to cherish our natural environment.
And so, the leaves right now are gorgeous. And you can feel that little crisp in the air, can't you?
It is getting chilly out there.
Yeah,
it's starting to change.
You're going to have to start bundling up. Well, tell me about this ride that you're going to be doing. I was looking at the map, and I see where it ends in Fort Bragg. That's where my husband and I spent part of our honeymoon. That's a lovely town. And so tell us about the ride.
Yeah, I'm getting really excited. We're kicking this whole thing off. This Saturday, we drive down, and the ride will begin on Sunday. So what we're going to do is, you know, I'm in a power wheelchair. I'm paralyzed from the neck down. And, you know, I love to have adventures, you know, cycle tours or something. I loved before I was injured. And, you know, I have to kind of do it in a different way, but I can still celebrate that passion. So our plan is to start in Brookings, Oregon, which is about 7 miles north of the California-Oregon border, right along the coast. And we will do about 40 miles per day and slowly make our way down to Fort Bragg, California. And, you know, I do love that area, the Redwood Coast area. And I've driven through it a lot of times. But being able to see it at 7 miles per hour this year is going to be extra
special.
You
know, you really notice things a lot more than when you're in a wheelchair or on a bicycle or walking. You know, if you're in a car, you just drive past stuff and you're in your own little world. But you really can commune with nature when you're out there.
Well, yeah, for sure. And, you know, a lot of times in a car, you're kind of in your little bubble where when you're out there and you're on a bike or the wheelchair or whatever, you're in it. You're exposed. And I kind of like that. And, you know, there's always chances of rain and there's chances of heat and heavy fog or smoke. And those are challenges that we recognize that we could come across, but we'll get through them. And it's going to be all worth it.
Well, I know when Tama called me and said that I was going to have you as a guest today, I went to your website, and that's E-N-I-A-N-S-R-I-D-E, correct?
Ian'sRide.com is the website. And what's cool is that we, every day at the end of our ride, we do two things. First, we call KSQM, and we give an update on our story for the day and tell you how the adventure went. And then we sit down and we start blogging so that we can also tell the story on, you know, at least in paper form or word form. And we'll have pictures and stuff posted onto that website, iansride.com.
Now, when was it that you did the ride across Washington? Was that 2018?
Well, I went from north to south Washington in 2016.
Okay.
Started in Canada and finished in Portland. But yeah, in 2018, we started in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, and rode all the way to Port Angeles. And that was some serious challenges because of the heat of eastern Washington, and I'm unable to regulate my temperature. So trying to keep me shaded and use ice vests to cool off, you know, it was a different experience, but we made it work.
And the mountains, that was a challenge.
And then the Cascades, yeah, when there's a mountain range in between you and your destination, there's a heck of a challenge. But we had a great time. And you know, the smoke also was trouble. And unfortunately, that just seems to be the way things are going in the summers in the West.
Yeah, and I heard Ed Evans say that we might have some smoke from the California fires coming in. So,
yeah, we'll see.
Well, let's do a song. Right now I have in a different room, but through the glass from me, I have Ian MacKay. Did I get it right?
You nailed it.
Awesome. Ian MacKay, and he is going to start a trip on Sunday in his wheelchair with his support group that we'll hear more about after this song. But here's Jimmy Reed, and all some of these songs have been specifically loaded for you, Ian.
Nice.
And this is Side of the Road. Do you think that's appropriate?
That seems very appropriate.
Okay, so here's Jimmy Reed with Side of the Road, K-Swim 91.5.
Me and my baby walking down the road, and we spotted a man and a 64. Let us ride. He's a loving giant. Better move aside. I said, "Oh, me and my baby."
Okay, so that was Jimmy Reed with Side of the Road, 24 minutes past one. You're tuned to K-Squim 91.5. In the adjacent booth from me, I have Ian Mackay. I got to work on it. Tama says, practice, practice, practice.
Oh, you're three for three.
And Ian Mackay is going to start a wheelchair extravaganza on Sunday. So tell us more about the support team that you have to make this successful.
Yeah. Well, we realized early on that, I would need others with me, especially cyclists, because, it would be awesome if our infrastructure had, bike paths all the way down the state or, for long distances, but that's not the reality. And I'll be on the Pacific Coast bike route, but much of that still is on the highway. And the shoulders are pretty wide, and I feel comfortable out there. But I mainly feel comfortable because I have my team with me. And I have at least three cyclists with me at all time, just to increase visibility. I also have flags on my chair, and I wear a big canopy. It's a bright color, and I do everything I can to maximize my exposure. I'll also be bringing just some folks to help me in the evenings, right? I need care as far as I need help with getting into bed and everything like that. And, my mom is going to be joining us, and she's going to be driving as well as helping out in the nighttime stuff. And I will be bringing one other caregiver. But it's important to have a good sized crew because, this is difficult. I'm a trached, paralyzed man, and I'm a pretty high level injury, and planning ahead, trying to make this successful, usually all depends on individuals and support, both of my crew and also the greater community that helps me finance this. I mean, I have to have six folks out there with me, and I got to pay for lodging and food for that, and You know, it also brings me to how appreciative I am of KSQM, and I want to say a big thank you. And you know, I'm all about supporting local radio, but you guys have supported me through all of these journeys, and it's really fun every day to come to the end of the ride and then, you know, be able to feel like I'm talking to everyone back home and tell that story.
To give everyone an update of what challenges you met that day.
Yeah.
Because I'm sure that every day is different.
You got it. And, you know, the fundraising that we do, I mean, it does support this trip, but there's a lot more to it. I do a lot of speaking engagements after these rides to tell people kind of about what I do and the importance of outdoor accessibility. And then we're even doing things more like for the local community. We're right now talking with the people working on the new Dream Playground across from Civic Field there on Race in Port mm-hmm. Angeles.
Yeah.
And they're making this fully accessible park, or not playground, right there in the park. And one thing we really love is the idea of an accessible merry-go-round where a wheelchair can just roll right on as a kid.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, and so, you know, those are things that we are looking into grant writing for, and also that are the donations.
Well, now, you mentioned fundraising. I'm sure that people that are listening, hopefully there are people out there. Yeah. We're having a fund drive right now, but if they're going, you know, I'd like to support Ian in this adventure, how could they do that?
Yeah, well, the easiest way is probably just to go to that website, iansride.com, and click the donate button. But just following along, just hearing those cheers of enthusiasm and excitement and knowing that the people back home are enjoying our adventure is huge, too. But yes, you know, we do have to continue raising money to make our mission a reality, and yeah, to do
so
that.
So how many days is this going to be? It's going to start on Sunday and end on Saturday?
You got it. It's 7 days. And originally, I had planned on going across Oregon from east to west. That was the plan for 2020. But then 2020 happened. And,
nothing has been like it should have been for 2020.
So we had to pivot a little bit, and we wanted to pick somewhere that was very isolated, and you know, I could have very little interaction with the general public. And we're just going to be doing Airbnbs down the coast, and that way we can, you know, have a whole house to ourselves and feel safe. But, you know, a big part of my rides every year has always been enjoying a craft beer at the end of the
I've seen pictures, and when you've posted pictures, and...
Yeah, it's kind of like every day the, you know, the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow for us.
I can make it a few more miles.
And
yes.
there's such good breweries in the area we're going through. However, again, because of the 2020 stuff and wanting to be respectful to local regulations, we may have to forego visiting the breweries and just picking up some cans and bottles and bringing them back to Airbnb and enjoying them there.
And that's a good way to compensate for not actually being able to go into a brewery.
Yeah, and I always say, I mean, the two really wonderful things about doing these rides is being on the open road with your friends, the people that you love, and then also at the end of the day, having that, you know, the cold one and kind of discussing how the day went and what the highlights were for everybody and, oh, did you see this and did you see that? And, yeah, it's, I think it's important to follow your passions. And in my experience, people love seeing others complete their goals, and that's why I share this all with you.
Yeah, well, let's, I have a special interest in psychology.
Oh.
So, yes. So, let's go ahead and listen to a song. I think let's hear from Old Crow Medicine Show, Wagon Wheel. And then I'd like you to talk about how you started going outside and enjoying the outdoors and getting yourself out of this funk that you were in.
Will do.
I think that all of us could learn something from this because, as we've said, 2020, there has been nothing normal about 2020. So let's hear from Old Crow Medicine Show, Wagon Wheel, and then we'll come back. We have Ian MacKay, right?
You got it.
4 out of 4. I got it. Ian MacKay, and he's talking about his trip that he's going to be taking in his wheelchair. But right now, let's hear some music. 29 minutes to 2, K-Squim 91.5. That was Old Crow Medicine Show with Wagon Wheel. You're tuned to K-Squim 91.5. I'm Sassy Susan. And in the adjoining room with me to observe COVID, we have Ian McKay. I got it. 5 out of 5. Okay. And he was talking earlier about this trip that he's going to be taking along through the Redwoods in his wheelchair with his support crew. And before we went to the song, I asked if he would share some of his thoughts about, you know, I'm sure that you were really depressed when all this first happened. How did you dig out of it? How did you come up with the strength to... Because we're all facing things like this. Nothing like what you faced, but we all have our challenges.
Yeah, most definitely.
So and how do you reach in there?
In some ways, it's still even hard to talk about.
Well,
because
if you don't want to talk about
it,
that's okay.
I love to. I'd love to share this story. But, you know, thinking back at those times, I was 26 years old when I was riding my bicycle home from college and crashed and broke my neck and became a quadriplegic. And, you know, at that age, you have so many plans going forward and your friends. And I, you know, was just living with college roommates, and everything changed, you know, in a blink of an eye when my neck broke. And spent 3 months in the hospital before ultimately coming up to the Olympic Peninsula. I no longer could live with my roommates in college. And it was probably about 2 years of just a big depression, of dark times, and trying to kind of rediscover myself and figure out where do I go from here, and everything had changed so much. We identify so well and with our bodies, and I needed to, I don't know, boil myself down to more than that.
Yeah.
And, you know, in the beginning, I really just tried to say, okay, clearly, you know, computers are the way I'm going to go forward. I can't move my body, but I can still interact with a computer well, and that's going to be my future. But I realized quickly that was never what I wanted to do, and I couldn't recreate myself. And so what I did was I went and explored the Olympic Discovery Trail. And at first I was really nervous because it's only maybe a third of a mile from my house, but I was going off alone, and that was scary for me at that time. But I started to explore and do a mile or 2 miles, and, you know, soon I was doing 30 miles out there and being able to watch the seasons change and see the first crocuses popping up, or, you know, just seeing maybe the goldfinches come migrating in. It made me realize that it was the outdoors is where I always found my solace, and I didn't need to reinvent that, and I needed to just embrace it. And I think that's a lot what these rides are about, is finding my love of nature and just realizing the calming and soothing effects that it has, at least on me, when I'm out there underneath those big trees.
Yeah, there's something about being outdoors. I know when I'm outside, you know, you look at things and you go, oh, I had never noticed that. Or you hear the birds, or you look at, oh, those trees have budded out. Those weren't budded the other day.
Yeah, watching change throughout the year can really give some excitement to you.
Change is constant.
It's
always happening.
And I think that's an important thing for us all to recognize during the 2020 times, is that things are difficult, but, you know, this too will change. But you know, we have to all get through it in our own ways. And I think finding those things that bring us happiness are more important than ever right now, and trying to embrace those.
Yeah, we have to kind of dig a little deep in ourselves and find out what makes us tick. It's not necessarily stuff.
No, often it's not. And I think that we have been able to recognize the importance of interaction with others during this, and when we are limited to that, how much that affects us. And you know, that's a big thing with my crew, is that they are down there isolating themselves for 2 weeks so that they can come up and be around me and be part of this, and that we can still enjoy each other's company.
What a commitment for them.
Yeah, it is. And you know, it definitely makes me feel loved, and it allows us to enjoy the trip all the more.
Yeah. Well, awesome. Well, that was very introspective and helpful. I've taken just enough psychology courses to be dangerous, you know, and I think psychology is so interesting, of how two children raised with the same parents can turn out so different. But you know, you just, we all have to take each day as it comes. And you are a testament. Well, let's, here's a song that I think is appropriate for you. It's called The Cape.
Because Guy Clark.
We're going to, because you have a cape on. You might not realize it, but you are a Superman. And so here's Guy Clark. Wait,
before you start, let me just say something real quick. Is when I was in the hospital within those first, I think, 2 weeks, some of my closest friends came in there with their guitars, and they sang this song to me over the hospital bed. And so, yes, this song has a special place in my heart.
Now you're going to make me cry. And I cry so easily. My sister will attest to that. But that is a wonderful backstory for this. So your friends came and sang this to you in the hospital.
Yeah, they had to sneak a guitar into the ICU. And
they had to spray it down with Lysol so it didn't have any bugs on it.
It meant the world to me.
Okay, so here's Guy Clark with The Cape. K-Squib 91.5.
8 years old with a flannel sack cape tied all around his neck. He climbed up on the garage, he's figuring what the heck. Screwed his courage up so tight that the whole thing come unwound. He got a running start and bless his heart, he headed for the ground. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cape. He's all grown up with a flower sack cape tied all around his dreams. And he's full of piss and vinegar, and he's busting at the seams. So he licked his finger and checked the wind, it's gonna be do or die. He wasn't scared of nothing, boys, he's pretty sure he could fly. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cape. Flower sack cape tied all around his head. And he's still jumping off the garage and will be till he's dead. All these years the people said he's acting like a kid. He did not know he could not fly, so he did. Well, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Trust your cape. Yeah, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cape. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cape.
Lovely song.
Love it. Love that one.
Yep. That was Guy Clark with The Cape. And we have in the booth, socially distancing, of course, we have Ian MacKay. And I'm going to learn it. Tama's going to bum it into my head to make sure I pronounce it right. And Ian is talking about this ride that he's going to take. And it is so exciting. So you're going to keep us posted on KSQM of how things are going every day, right?
For sure. And yeah, please, guys, jump on around 5:30 starting this Sunday and the 6 days following, where, yeah, I'll be in here and I'll be telling my story. And you can You can hear how we did on the side of the road each day for 40 miles.
Yeah, we already played the side of the road.
So, I mean, it's 272 miles, and it's ambitious for a power wheelchair.
Yeah. Do you have extra batteries that you're going to be taking, or what?
So, yeah, that's an interesting question. Usually we always have a second wheelchair that we bring, because if the hills do get too big and we run out of juice, I need something to keep me moving for the day.
Yeah.
But we're going to try to do this with one chair this year and an additional battery. However, there's been some delays in shipping because of various natural disasters in our nation.
2020.
Yes.
Blame everything on 2020.
And my extra battery, I mean, I have two on board, which should be able to get me the distance I need to go every day. But I have an additional one coming, but it's not going to get there until about halfway through the ride, and it'll be dropped off at an Airbnb.
So. Yeah.
So we've got good plans there, but, The best laid plans
sometimes don't work. Well, let's do the weather, and then I'm going to have you come back and give one more shout out on how people can support you and how they can follow you, and how's that for a deal?
That sounds great.
Okay, so right now it's 14 minutes to 2. You're tuned to KSQM 91.5, and let's give you the weather report, the afternoon weather report for Tuesday, September 29th. And this is made possible through the support of Sunny Farms Country Store. The National Weather Service says warm and dry weather is expected across the area this week, with slightly cooler temperatures forecast by the weekend. Today will be sunny with a high near 73, which we just made 73. Yes, mostly clear tonight, low around 54. Wednesday is going to be Wednesday is going to be sunny with a high near 75, a little bit warmer tomorrow. Thursday is mostly sunny with a high around 71, sunny on Friday and 71. Saturday is sunny with a high near 70. On Sunday, mostly sunny, but a slight chance of rain and a high around 68. And on Monday, mostly sunny with a slight chance of rain and a high of 67. This afternoon's weather report is a service of the KSQM News Center and is made possible through the support of Sunny Farms Country Store. Right now in downtown Squim, it is 73 degrees, 62% humidity, barometer 30.10, and the wind has dropped off a little bit. It's 2 to 3, but still out of the northeast. So in the booth with me, we're going to tie up this a little bit because Ian has someplace that he needs to be, but I have socially distancing in the next room with a glass between us, Ian Mackay, and he is going to be starting his trip in his wheelchair from Brookings, Oregon to Fort Bragg. See, I remembered the Fort Bragg because that's where my husband and I had our honeymoon. So Brookings, how many miles is it?
272 miles.
And so he is going to be in his wheelchair with his support crew. And if you want to support him financially, because there are expenses, how can they do that?
I'm going to give you three ways that you
can
really
support me. Okay, three ways. Okay, you can pick your choice.
Financially is huge. I mean, we do have to keep business expenses covered for the nonprofit.
Right.
And you can do that at iansride.com and hit the donate button. Another way that you can support, though, is tuning in between Sunday and next Saturday and hearing how things went and giving us some feedback and call in at 5:30 and ask questions and give us some thumbs up or criticism, whatever.
So
you're
going to be giving an update on KSQM, right?
On KSQM.
On KSQM. Okay. Yep. Another reason to listen to KSQM.
Every day at 5:30 after the ride's done. On that same line, you can also read the blog at iansride.com. But the third way that you can support kind of our mission and me is go outside. Go have some fun out there, even if it's just your backyard, or let's say you're on a scooter. Go explore the new paved path on Hurricane Hill on Hurricane Ridge.
I heard that they had just finished
It's wonderful. Me and my grandfather got to go ride up there
on
his scooter, and it's beautiful. And just that we can access those areas now is really important. And I think the more exposure areas get to lack of access, the more change that happens. And we're all getting older, and we're all going to have mobility issues at some point. And being able to see the beauty around us is really important.
So I love that. That was beautiful the way you said that, not only financially, but get outside. That's a good way to pay it forward.
hey, that's what we do, and that's really what the nonprofit is all about, is giving people access to the outdoors. And especially around here, we have to really enjoy it and embrace it.
That's right.
We are very fortunate.
So this is Ian's Ride, IANSRIDE, IansRide.com, and you can make a financial contribution, and you can follow his blog. I'm so glad that I looked up a little bit to be a little bit more informed before I had you on air with me today. But tune in at 5:30 every day. And you'll get an update of what challenges Ian faced that day while you are having your cold brew.
Yeah, and thank you guys so much for hearing the story and listening, and we hope to be talking more in the coming week.
Okay, well, I think I had three options to pick from for songs, and we're going to hear from the Grateful Dead with Truckin'.
All right.
A lot of things going on right now. And we just had Ian McKay. I screwed it up. Ian, he laughs. He's laughing at me now. He's doing some recording in the room next door. So it's Ian McKay, and he is talking about his trip that he's going to be doing on his wheelchair starting Sunday until Saturday. If you want to know what how his day has gone, tune into KSQM at 5:30 every day, and he will give you an update.